Hello, I'm Desmond Du, and today I'm going to show you my favorite cheat expression in After Effects to speed up your animation workflow. So, let's get started. So, for the first cheat tutorial I want to share with you is the wiggle function. The wiggle function, what it does is that it randomly shakes a property of a layer. So it's very helpful when it comes to create random motion. For example, in this scene over here, right, we have this orb that's traveling through space, through this hyperspace. So maybe if you were to do this manually, maybe what you'll do is that you keyframe the position, right, and then you shift it to a random position and you move down a few seconds and you do the same thing and over again. Or you may even tweak the animation path by using the pen tool by pressing G, right? So I can add a new keyframe. So let's play that and see what happens. And you can see it works, right? But here's the thing, you know, it doesn't really look very natural. And it feels very, very controlled, right? It's not, like I said, you know, using this method, it works, but we want to introduce more motion, more randomness, so that it really looks like it's traveling through space. So this is where the wiggle function comes in. So let's get rid of the keyframe by clicking on the stopwatch and hold down Option on Mac and Alt on Windows, right? This will allow us to enter our first expression. And what we want to type in is wiggle, parentheses, so 0.1, and then maybe about 400. So the first input that we have over here, right, 0.1, is actually the frequency, so how fast. And the second input is the amplitude, so how intense or how much the randomness should be. So just remember, right, we're wiggling by how fast, by how much. So I'm gonna just click outside and then I'm gonna play it. And as you can see, right now the orb is moving, right? And it's on the top over here, but very slowly. If I wanna increase the speed of the random movement, maybe I can change the first value to be 5, right, and play it. So that's a little bit too much. So let's go back down to maybe about just 1.5 so we can find a sweet spot. So this might work depending on the speed, you know, how fast you want this orb to go through this hyperspace portal over here. And a question you might have is that, how do I know what expression does, what a function does, where do we reference it? So what we can do is go to Google, right? And we can type in After Effects expression reference as I have over here. So if you go down to the first link by A. Hanser, we can go search, right? So this is a dictionary for After Effects expressions. So if I'm curious about what wiggle do, right, I can type in wiggle and I can see a bunch of options over here. So I can click on it. And then after that, I can read up about what this wiggle function does. So as I mentioned, right, the first input is frequency and the second input is amplitude. And the description of the function is to randomly shake the value of a property. So every time you feel lost about an expression, always come back to this After Effects expression guide. So that's the first cheat expression I have for you. So for the next cheat expression I want to show you is called Ignore Parent Scale. And it pretty much does what it says, right? So if we have a layer that is parented to a null layer, it's going to ignore the scale of the scale increase from the null layer and remain the same. So this is good when we want to animate multiple layers, just have in a way exploding or spreading further away from a null layer. So instead, let's just say if you want this radial ring of squares to kind of spread out, right? If you were to do this manually using keyframes, you might select one layer. So I'm gonna press Command-Shift-H to show my layer control so you can see where it is. So you might do this manually. You might grab one layer, put a keyframe, and then after that, push it down. And then you select another layer, press P, you put a keyframe down, right? And then you move it outwards. So this technique is it's very tedious, especially when it comes to working with lots of layer. And if you want to get the angle of this radio explosion correct, it's very hard to eyeball it to get it to be correct. So what we want to do is to parent it to now and animate the scale. So let me first get rid of the keyframes for these two squares, right? So I'm going to select all the keyframes. I'm going to hit Command A to select all the layers, and I'm going to pick with it to the now layer to parent them. So I'm gonna undo that because I already have some keyframes here on my control. It's gonna press U and undo that. And then I'm gonna select all my my sprite layer, right? And then pick with it to the control layer. And you know, as you can see, if the keyframes here, right, my scale actually goes from 0 to 72. And it actually works just like that if you want to have an explosion. But the thing is that you might not want the squares to scale down in size. You want to keep it a constant. So this is where we start using the ignore parent scale expression. So let's press S on our sprite layer and hold down Option and click on the stopwatch to enter our expression. So the expression goes like this. Right? First of all, we need to specify the value. We need to get the X value, the X scale of our layer's scale property. We can do that by defining a variable called S is equals to value square bracket 0, because we're working with an array. Scale has two values, right? A set of two values, the X and the Y scale, and then semicolon. And then we need to reference the parent scale. So we'll create a variable called PS is equals to parent.transform.scale.value. And then we need to reference the X scale. So that's square bracket 0 to reference the first element of the array. And now we can make the ignore parent scale by typing S times 100 divided by, which is denoted by a slash PS semicolon. And then like I mentioned earlier on, the scale takes in two values. So if we leave it like this, we're gonna get an error, right? So what we need to do is to create a variable called V, or it could be any letter that you want. We just need a variable to hold value. And then we'll create an array by typing a square bracket and then type in V comma V, because we want it to be a constrained proportion, right? We don't want to skew it and have different scale value for the X and Y, so you can see that it works. So now I can copy this expression, right click, copy expression, command A to select all the layer, hold down command to deselect the control layer, and command V to paste the expression onto the other layers, okay? So now if we were to play it, you can see that. Notice the size, right? The size of the squares are constant despite being scaled by the now layer, right? So that's the benefit of using the ignore parent scale expression. All right, so for the next cheat expression, I'm gonna show you the time expression. So this is very useful for creating perpetual motion, so motion that doesn't stop. So for example, in this animation we made over here, right, we have the radio explosion as well as a rotation. So if I want to introduce the rotation, a perpetual rotation to this setup over here, what I can do usually is to set my third keyframe at the back, right, and set it to a number, say 180. Maybe I can push it back all the way to the end of the composition. So I'm just going to press play. So as you can see, right, we have that rotation, but you can see there's a dip over here where at our second keyframe, because the speed doesn't match up to the first set of motion we have over here, right? You can see if I play it here, if I just play from 1 second onwards, right? It suddenly starts moving somewhere after the second keyframe. So we don't want that. We want to keep it all consistent. So let's get rid of the third keyframe over here, and let's put an expression onto the rotation property by holding down Option, click on the stopwatch. And what we can do is to type in time times 40. So the time expression, it will retrieve, well, the time value where your current playhead is. So if you can see on my left where my cursor is, right, it's gonna retrieve the value from there. So time times 40 will be the velocity or the speed. So we can actually create a variable called speed, right? Or actually there are some reserved words that we can't use, such as speed. So maybe we might call it my speed is equals to time times 40 semicolon. And we also want our original value from the keyframe animation. So what we need to type is my speed plus value, okay? So if I were to play this now, you can see that I have my primary motion moving, right? At the start, at the first second, but then, you know, this circle, this radio array just continued to move throughout the whole composition. And even if I extend the duration of this composition, you can be sure that it will keep spinning, and it's based on this expression we have over here, time times 40. If we want it to be slower, maybe we can type in time times 10. So the lower the number, right, the slower it goes. Very similar to the wiggle expression I covered previously. And of course, if I want it to be faster, I'll increase the value, say 100, right? So you can use the time expression to create all this secondary motion. Alright, so I hope you enjoyed this video. Don't forget to follow Domestika on social media. Also, if you're interested in learning more about coding in After Effects, please check out my online course on Domestika.